since I could walk, I was playing soccer. And then when I was about eight, got put into football. I actually played guard my first year. The next year I started playing tight end, and I started playing linebacker. And when the season was about to start, we needed to find a kicker. So they lined us up in a big line, and pretty much whoever did it the best was gonna be the kicker. So I was like, well, you know, I play soccer. And I got on there and I did it soccer style, and I made the first one. They're like, okay, do it again. And I made my next one. And they're like, all right, you're our kicker.
Right here, about 12 years ago, I kicked my first football through these uprights. This is where I began kicking a football, so.
The son of Mexican immigrants, Roberto Aguayo, grew up in Mascot, Florida, where football, not soccer, provided an early path.
We saw a better future in that for scholarships, so we decided to go the football route then.
Aguayo nails this 21-yarder.
Aguayo committed to Florida State, then went on to win a national championship and the Lou Groza Award, the highest honor for a college kicker. Leaving FSU as the most accurate kicker in ACC history, he was drafted by Tampa Bay in the second round.
The Tampa Bay Buccaneers select Roberto Aguayo, kicker, Florida State.
The highest a kicker has been selected in more than a decade.
I've kicked in that stadium before. It just feels homey to me. Very excited to get the season going and see how well we can do, and I guess the sky's the limit for us.
Those limitless skies were made possible by the sacrifices of Aguayo's father, Roberto Sr., who at age 18 left his family's home in central Mexico to head north of the border.
He wanted a better future for his family back home, and you know, the way to make more money and was coming to the United States, you know, in the fields, and he just got paid more than what they got paid back in Mexico.
The elder Aguayo was twice deported back to Mexico. Despite those setbacks, he kept returning to the United States, and in 1984, became a U.S. citizen.
Después de tener toda esa travesía que hice para intentar venir aquí a Estados Unidos, estoy súper, súper contento.
Well, he really wanted to be a professional soccer player, and I think if he would have stayed back home, there he could have made it professionally, but at the time, that wasn't gonna bring the money. And when he came over here, you know, all the soccer was lost, and he was happy. Now that I'm at a professional level, he lives it through us.
Roberto Sr.'s sacrifice continues to pay off. Ricky Aguayo is now a kicker at Florida State, following in his older brother's footsteps.
I just wish, you know, growing up, I had a mentor like I am to him.
Que yo quiero es que, pues, verdad, disfruten de lo que hacen. Que se mantengan firmes en lo que van a hacer, seguir trabajando y echarle ganas a la vida.
Now, the immigrant's son is a bright spot for one of the most promising young rosters in the league.
Aguayo from 48 yards away. He's got it.
At the end of the day, this career, this job's gonna end. There's gonna be a lot more kickers, but the one thing that I want people to know or people to get out of is just being a good person, and not just, oh, I'm a great kicker, I'm a great football player, but parents can say to their kids, hey, look at Roberto, he's a great person. Having that effect on not only Hispanic kids, but having that effect to everyone, I think that's my goal, so people can see that, and, you know, maybe one day I can be like Roberto, and no matter what culture.